We're discussing the different types of facelift techniques and which one is best or which ones are better than the others. Just like anything in life, you get out of life or whatever it is you're doing, something similar to what you put into it. So if you are attempting to correct a major problem with a very minor surgery, you're most likely not going to get the result you're looking for. In terms of facelifting, this is true up until a point. During the course of the last 10 to 20 years, we've used various different techniques that have depended on the depth of the surgery in terms of the facial anatomy. So without getting into too many details of the anatomy of the face, we initially only addressed the skin. Then people started looking at layers beneath the skin, which included different layers of muscle, other strong supportive tissue, all the way down to the bone. And what we've generally realized is just addressing the skin is not enough. That does not produce long-term results. So there's a layer just below the skin called the smas, S-M-A-S, which is a support structure that supports all of the underlying soft tissue of the face. And as long as you address the smas by either elevating it or putting sutures or stitches in it, or by some means supporting it and supporting all of the structures beneath it, then you do not have to pull the skin as tight as we once thought we needed to pull the skin. In addition, people have found that we really don't need to go deeper than the level of the smas because the risk of complications tends to go up as you get deeper and as you get closer to really important structures, and the benefit of these dissections do not outweigh the risks. So a properly performed full facelift, not a facelift that is performed in 30 minutes, but a true facelift performed by a board-certified plastic surgeon that addresses the smas level of the face, in my opinion, is the best way to perform a facelift.